is on administrative leave, accused of giving a student prescription drugs. Good evening. I'm Adrian Whitsett.
And I'm Melissa Fry. Council Bluffs police say Adam Jones gave a student Xanax. He's now on administrative leave from Thomas Jefferson High School.
KTV News Watch 7's Amanda Crawford is live with information from investigators. Amanda?
Adrian and Melissa, police first started investigating Jones because he was accused of sending text messages to a female student. That investigation led them to the prescription drugs.
Council Bluffs police say an anonymous tip is what prompted them to investigate a science teacher at Thomas Jefferson High School. Now, Adam Jones is charged with the delivery of a controlled substance, Xanax. According to police records, Jones told police he had not given the student Xanax, but he knew the student had taken some. Jones also admitted to sending provocative text messages like, quote, "I want you." Police say the text messages were sent after the student turned 18.
The text messaging, as far as the police department is concerned, it didn't rise to the level where any criminal laws were broken.
While police say the texting did not cross any legal lines, the school superintendent says the school is conducting their own investigation because they may have different standards.
If the action was inappropriate, according to our policy, we may take action whether the courts decide this is a crime or not.
Bruckner says Jones has been teaching at Thomas Jefferson for 4 years. Until last week, she had not heard a complaint against him.
He was on administrative leave within about three hours of us hearing about it.
Bruckner says since the alleged drug exchange happened off of school grounds, that is out of their control. But she says the text messages could cost Jones his job.
And I would promise you that we will take the action that is most warranted.
Police say both Jones and the student were open about the Xanax pills and the text messages.
Clearly, whenever we're getting the same story from both parties involved, obviously, you know, we've got the truth.
The Pottawatomie County attorney says Jones will be in court in 3 weeks. He says the student will not be charged for allegedly having those Xanax pills. The school tells us no other students were really involved in the investigation, and again, that there's no physical proof that anything physically inappropriate happened between Jones and the student. Reporting in Council Bluffs, Amanda Crawford, KETV News Watch 7.